They edged deeper still, continuing to hold hands in a chain. Cassandra was right. It was dim rather than dark now, and they could make out the path in front of them more clearly. They were moving faster, feeling braver. They were just squeezing their way around a labyrinth of thick tree trunks, careful not to trip over the large, snake-like tree roots, turning the forest floor into a natural obstacle course, when they saw an eerie glow up ahead. They clambered over more roots and a fallen log, around another gnarled tree trunk, and then...
"What is that?" Cassandra cried. "It's so beautiful!" Katie gasped.
In the middle of a small clearing, they saw what looked like a giant lantern glowing a bright, fluorescent, greeny yellow. It was made from an intricate construction of twigs, while the light inside seemed to be pulsing, as though alive. Zia took a few steps closer, straining to get a better look.
"It's full of insects," she whispered,
pointing to a lantern where, inside, they could now make out a collection of hundreds, no, thousands of beetle-like bugs packed tightly together with brightly glowing abdomens.
"They must be glowworms. My mum's told me about them before. Only the females glow. The light is made by a chemical reaction in their bodies. It's called bioluminescence, I think."
Zia's mum was a scientist, and Zia always knew lots of exciting facts.
"This has to be the foxes," said Thunder. "I bet this is what they meant when they talked about turning lights on in the forest."